Hey everyone, I'm Braden, and I'm Herp Enthusiast, and I'm here with Ian Garrison from technoendo, and we're here at the Portland Metro Reptile Expo, and we're just checking things out.
Snakes before?
I have, but usually I really only use simple methods like tape measures and stuff like that.
Have you ever heard of an image and software measurement technique?
I can't say that I have. How does that work?
Basically, you put a snake down on the ground, you put a reference object next to it, you take a photo, and you use software to trace out how long the snake is.
Well, that's interesting.
Yeah. Maybe we can go run some tests. You can help me figure out how accurate it is.
Yeah, sure. Let's do that.
Cool. Thanks, man.
Yeah.
It was great meeting Braden for the first time at the expo and enlist some testing help. Between a tape measure and photo and software measurements, which method is more accurate and to what degree? Let me show you a better demonstration on how a photograph and software can be used to measure snakes. To get started, you'll need a camera, snake, and measurement reference object of some kind. I'll be using an 8.5 by 11 inch sheet of paper. You'll need to take a direct overhead photograph of a snake on a flat surface with your measurement object in the photo. The picture should be taken from directly overhead to keep the perspective from distorting the measurement. If you run Windows, you can download Snake Measure Tool from SourceForge, then install and run the software. If you don't have Windows, check out Serpentine Widget Snake Measurer as it's web-based and it'll run in any web browser. For this video, I'll be focused on Snake Measure Tool, but the process is similar in both tools. Open your measurement photograph in Snake Measure Tool. The first thing the software will have you do is click and draw a line on the image to set a length on your measurement object. Once the line is drawn, Snake Measure Tool will ask you to enter a number for how long the single line segment is. Units do not matter. Since I'm using an 8.5 inch piece of paper, I'll enter 8.5. Now you will click and draw a series of connected line segments along the spine of the snake. It doesn't matter if you start at the head or the tail.
That's it, you are done. Look at the top right-hand corner for your measurement, 51.6 inches in this case. Let's measure some snakes.
Show you my data soon enough. First, let's check in with HerpEnthusiast. Whenever I'm passing through Bend, Oregon, I like to make a stop by the reptile zone to see some of their native and exotic reptiles. I've seen the owner Jeff delighting families with his animal facts, sometimes showing them animal feedings, and once I watched him send a kid out the door wide-eyed with a shed cobra skin clutched in one hand. Even if you don't have a need to pick up any reptile pet supplies, it's a fun stop to make before rolling out onto Oregon's high desert to find wild reptiles. Jeff was kind enough to lend a few snakes to help with our project. Hey, thanks, Jeff! We've got a king snake and rubber boa to work with, and Braden is testing with a metal tape measure. Also, his measurement reference object is a 25-cent coin. Braden, great seeing you at the Reptile Expo, man.
Yeah, it was great to see you too, Ian. I'm glad we could finally meet up.
Look at all those tanks in Herp Enthusiast land. How many species are you keeping at home?
Right now, I've actually got 12 different species. It started out as a really small collection, but I've steadily grown it over the past 5 or 6 years, and now we've got plenty of animals. I actually have a good mix of native and exotic species, so we've got a pretty diverse collection of animals here in my room. One of my most recent accomplishments is I actually bred my adult pair of oscillated geckos together, and I got a little baby guy right here. He's actually super cute, but it actually inspired me to start up a few more breeding projects here in the coming year, so I should have a few more species added to my list that I am breeding.
Way cool, man!
Yeah, now that we have some snake measurements, we should go over our results, shall we?
Yes, let's get into it. The first item I wanted to mention is some of the variables involved in both tape and image measurement systems. You won't be getting good measurements unless you make an effort to control these variables and minimize human error. One thing that surprised me was that you got more accurate measurements with a rigid tape measure. I thought you would need to use a cloth tape measure to get accurate measurements of snakes.
Yeah, that kind of surprised me too. I think one of the things that helped me out there was the fact that I used a really calm rubber boa and king snake, and they didn't really wriggle or move around that much, so I was able to straighten them out and I was able to get really accurate measurements.
Yeah, my ball python was bunching up, moving around, and being fussy, which skewed my tape measurements. So I came up with a scoring system with three metrics. First is the vary score, which is a standard deviation for all measurements in a set to describe how much variance there is. Second is a diff gap, which demonstrates the distance gap between tape and image measurements so we know how far off one method is from the other. And third, whichever method has the most measurements under an accuracy threshold wins. The most interesting item in this graph over the others was that this is the best image vary score of all our tests. Braden captured our lowest tape vary score of all measurements. It makes sense that fake rubber snakes would be the easiest to measure. Tape wins again! All of the tape data points have less than 1 centimeter of variance. Image measurements have more variance. Here's another winner, just like that last one. Rubber boas are as easy to work around as a pet rock. And here we have the highest tape vary of the data set. That ball python didn't enjoy being measured at all. So, tape measurements are the more accurate of the two methods. We got an average diff gap of about 2.54 inches between both, and we got a range of about 1/4 inch to 4 inches.
That's not too bad, actually. Actually, that would be a lot worse than that. However, there's still a few cases where the image-based technique might be worth using. It's probably better than eyeballing it. I'd say instances where you have a venomous species or a protected species that you can't touch, or situation where the animal's too fast and you can only capture a quick snapshot of it because you can't catch it.
Yeah, we did it, dude. I expected tape would come out on top, but learned a few new things here. Thanks for all your help on this project, Braden. Looking forward to seeing your next project on Herp Enthusiast.
Yeah, man, it was a really interesting project. It's too bad the image measurements aren't more accurate, but still a good lesson learned. So we should try another one of these collaborations sometime. Thanks for watching, everyone. Go measure some snakes. See you later.